Hello everyone, let's learn some basics about linked lists. First of all, what is a linked list? By the definition, a linked list is a linear data structure which is made up of nodes connected together by pointers. Each node has two main parts. The first part is the data part and the second part is the link part. The data part contains the data or the value to be stored in our node and the link part contains the address of the next node. Please note that each node is created dynamically, that is, as and when we require a node, we create it and memory is allocated to it. Let us try to understand linked lists by taking an example. Suppose we need to store integers 1, 2, and 3 in a linked list. We start by creating the first node. Let's say it is at an address 100 in the memory. We put 1 in the data part of this node, and as it is not pointing to any other node at this moment, we put null in the link part. Null means that this is the end of the list. Next, we create the second node. Let's say it is at an address 300 in the memory. We put 2 in the data part. Now we need to change some things. As we have a second node, we need to point the first node to the second node, which means the link part of the first node must contain the address of the second node. So we remove null and put 300 in the link part of the node. This means that node 1 is pointing to node 2. Similarly, as node 2 is not pointing to any other node, we put null in its link part. Now we create the third node. Let's say it is at an address 200 in the memory. We put 3 in the data part and similarly we change the link part of the second node to point to the third node. We remove null and put the address of the third node, which is 200, which means that it is pointing to the third node. And now as the third node is not pointing to any other node, we put null in its link part. We have successfully created three nodes and stored integers 1, 2, and 3 in each node. But we are missing something here. We need a head or a start pointer to point to the first node of the linked list. This pointer is used to access the linked list. So it will store 100, which is the address of the first node, which means it is pointing to the first node. And the first node is pointing to the second node, and the second node is pointing to the third node, which has null in its link part, which means it is the end of our linked list. Let's implement linked list in C++. This is the basic structure of our node. In C++, we use structure to make a node. The structure contains a data variable to store the data and a pointer to point to the next node. We use struct keyword here to create a structure and we name it as node. It has data which is of type integer. We can create any type, whether it be character, double, integer, depending on our need. Next, we have a link pointer which points to a node. So this overall structure we have created to implement linked list. Now let's make a simple program using our structure to create a node and put some value in its data section. First of all, we create the head pointer and we declare it as global, so that it can be accessed anywhere in the program. And we initialize it to null because right now it is not pointing to any node. We start with a main function. We use the new operator to dynamically allocate memory for our node and we return the starting address to the pointer PTR. Let's say the starting address is 100. Now we use this pointer PTR to put value 2 in the data part of our node. We do this using the right arrow operator, which is used to access the parts of our node using pointer. Similarly, we put null in the link part. Remember, we have to put null to show that this is the end of our linked list and the current node is not pointing to any other node. Finally, we need to equate head equal to PTR to copy the starting address of the node into head, thus pointing the head to the first node. And with this, we are done with our program. I hope this video was helpful and thank you for watching.